In this video, we're going to show you how to use the neoVI Fire 3. The neoVI Fire 3 is the most advanced multi-protocol vehicle network interface, gateway, and data logger. It works with most vehicle networks, including CAN, CAN-FD, LIN, Gigabit Ethernet for DoIP and XCP, and an optional FlexRay network. A few use cases for the Fire 3 are standalone data logging, wireless data logging, standalone ECU, vehicle simulation, and fleet management. The neoVI Fire 3 comes with 16 dual-wire CAN or CAN-FD channels with software-enabled CAN termination, 2 single-wire CAN channels, 8 LIN channels, 2 DoIP activation lines, 2 gigabit Ethernet channels, 2 full-size SD cards for up to 2 terabytes of storage with 800 megabits per second logging performance, internal dual-band Wi-Fi, absolute orientation sensor, buzzer, and more. In addition, on the front of the device, you will see 10 programmable tri-color LEDs. These membrane LEDs show link, error, and activity status, as well as membrane buttons to control triggered data logging. On the back of the device, you will find the pinout for the DB26 connector and antenna. On the top side of the case, you will find the barrel jack, 2 gigabit Ethernet connectors, and 2 full-size SD cards for data logging, as well as a USB Type-A connector for accessories such as the RAD-IO2 or the neoVI Mic 2 manual trigger. The bottom side of the case contains 2 HD26 male connectors and a port for GPS or Wi-Fi antenna. The neoVI Fire 3 is enclosed in an extruded aluminum case with rubber bumpers around the edges. This makes the device both durable and portable, ensuring easy testing no matter where you are. We are continuously adding new features for future releases. Some of the exciting new features that are currently under development are 4 channels of general purpose MISC-IO, instant wake up on 2 CAN-FD channels, Intrepid security module, generalized precision timing protocol, HD video logging via IP cameras, 2 SD cards with up to 4 terabytes of storage, and lastly, external modem support with Intrepid's RAD 4G. The neoVI Fire 3 also comes with new NXP CAN signal improvement capability and FlexRay configuration. One of the exciting features is the RAD-IO2 device support. The Fire 3 can also be paired with the ruggedized RAD-IO2 products that provide an isolated analog, digital, or temperature interface to a PC via USB Type-C. In addition, the RAD-IO2 family communicates on an open-source, UART-based serial communication protocol. Up to 4 devices can be daisy-chained, and the chain length is limited by the current supplied to the chain through USB. To configure your neoVI Fire 3, power the device with a barrel jack using the DC supply provided with your purchase or using the DB26 connector. Then connect your Fire 3 to your computer using the Ethernet cable and while also running our Vehicle Spy software. Once your device is connected to Vehicle Spy, go to neoVI Explorer to configure the hardware settings. One of the easiest ways to do this is by clicking on the Setup Hardware button located in the main Vehicle Spy toolbar, or by clicking on the Setup menu and then selecting Hardware. In neoVI Explorer, you will be able to update your neoVI firmware, change CAN network settings, LIN network settings, Ethernet port configuration, and much more. The neoVI Fire 3 also works with our Vehicle Spy X software. Vehicle Spy X is a cross-platform vehicle network software for automation, Python, AutoSAR, and more. Leverage the power of Vehicle Spy X's core library of functions and pair it with any of your favorite Python codes to minimize cost, maximize value, and increase efficiency. In addition, you can also use your neoVI Fire 3 device with our open source API on our GitHub page. we work hard to provide you with the best hardware and software experience. Not only does all our hardware go through a 24-hour burn-in test to find any potential problems, but we also do regression testing on our vehicle spy software. Please read our full documentation at intrepidcs.com/fire3 to learn more about this device. If you have any questions, please contact our support team. Thanks for watching.